March 1st, 1999. Our famous Chicago painter is so very generous, offering me an image of one of his paintings for the cover of my book. I go to his studio, where in the middle of piles of partly completed paintings, easels, drawings, he and his pals are having a sandwich, taking a break. Should they order me a tuna fish sandwich? Many immigrants could not read or write in English, or at all, and their education was, along with the daily newspapers, which were read aloud, public lectures and fugitive writings. The audiences at such lectures were often workers or people involved with organizing workers, people such as the young William Darrah Kelley, who left school to be an apprentice and yet was eager to learn and act, and became an organizer and teacher of young workers. Each generation had to be educated anew. And so Florence Kelley, soon after her arrival in Chicago, wrote to Henry Demarest Lloyd on Illinois Bureau of Statistics letterhead. June 30, 1892, Hull House. It rains every single day. It is rarely uncomfortably hot, but a trifle depressing. Bessie Nahinsky comes two evenings a week to read English with me, and with a class of 12 of her compatriots. She is going to a grammar school next year, living with her brother meanwhile. Pasha something or other, her pretty blonde cousin, Shapira, with all her brothers and cousins, are laboring through the third reader with me, and when they have finished, I mean to have them and read William Morris's News from Nowhere, and Moore's Utopia, and then Engels' Development of Socialism from Utopia to a Science. They are really intellectual, the whole dozen, and it is delightful to teach them.